Hi students, how are you all? We begin with the second semester. We start with history chapter Gupta Empire. Okay. Before that, let us discuss the history of India. Is divided into ancient Indian history, medieval Indian history, and modern Indian history. We have been discussing about ancient Indian history, and here also we are continuing discussing the ancient Indian history. How ancient Indian history? We began with Harappan civilization, that is Harappan people, how they established their cities, and about their town planning. All these we discussed about. So discussing the sources of Harappan people, like archaeological sources and literary sources. Like then we discuss about Buddha. What is that next chapter? Is that Vedic period, that is our arrival of Aryans from the central Asia, and they established Vedic civilization in India, and mainly literary sources like four Vedas. We discuss Ramayana, Mahabharata, and these are the important sources which help us to know the history of Vedic period. Then we learned about Buddhism and Jainism. We learned that what are the situation led to the establishment of Buddhism and Jainism. We know that religion has become so complex, so we wanted the society wanted a simple religion. So it was at that time there emerged Buddha and Mahavira. So they established Buddhism and Jainism. Then we learned about Mauryan Empire. The empires came into existence in India. How you know that Harappan civilization, those people use bronze, but which was the first metal to be discovered by man? Copper was the first metal. Okay, then mixing tin and lead, he made a bronze. So the Harappan people, they started making bronze tools. So he found that is better. So by the when we come to the Vedic period, by the end of early Vedic period, what happened? They discovered iron. You see, the discovery of iron brought about drastic changes in the life of man. Okay, so what happened? He cleared the forest and he started doing the cultivation. So once the cultivation improved, that has brought about lot of changes, development in the life of man. So there emerged some powerful persons. Why? Certain people know, they started earning lot of money, and also they started maintaining their own army. So once they started maintaining their own army, they became powerful. So they started conquering the surrounding region. So like that, there emerged kingship in India. Okay, so early Vedic period, you learn only Rajan was there. He was a tribal head and he was assisted by Sabha, Samiti. That means like a democracy. You know, he had to take the opinion from the council's members. Then he had to rule. He was not so powerful like. But when we come to later Vedic period, kingship emerged. Kings emerged in the society because of this situation. Iron. So clearing forest, maintaining army, earning money, strength. So capturing nearby territories, powerful persons emerged as king. So like the number of kingdoms emerged in India, but later on one of the major kingdom, the vast empire which ever existed in India, we discussed, that is Mauryan Empire. We learned the history that how the Mauryan Empire came into exist in India. So three important rulers of Mauryan Empire, like who are they? Chandragupta Maurya, Bindusara, then Ashoka. Three important rulers. So we learned in detail. Then at the end of Ashoka, you see, after the period of Ashoka, Mauryan Empire started declining. What was the main reason? Because Ashoka was least bothered of maintaining the army. Defense system is so important, isn't it? Why our present government, they purchase Rafale and all these things to strengthen our defense? Because we have problem with China, Pakistan. So we have to protect our country from our enemies. The similar way, the defense system is so important. But Ashoka, he ignored the army. So after the period, empire became so weakened, and it could easily attacked by the rulers, surrounding rulers. So again, disintegration of Mauryan Empire took place. Okay, so after that, you see, you can find only small kingdom in India. But after a short period, what happened? Again, Gupta Empire came to India. So Gupta Empire, under the Gupta rulers, India was again brought under a single ruler. But Gupta Empire was not so big as Mauryan Empire. But Gupta Empire, they could unify almost all the northern states, and also they could also influence certain extent their influence up to Central Asia. Okay, so we are going to discuss in this chapter about Gupta Empire. Three important rulers of Gupta Empire you should remember: Chandragupta first, then Samudragupta, and Chandragupta second, or Chandragupta Vikramaditya. Three important rulers of Gupta Empire. And we also discuss about the sources of Gupta Empire. When we discuss about the sources of Gupta Empire, you know, Fahian's accounts. Fahian was a Chinese traveler or pilgrimage, means Buddhist, means he was a Buddhist pilgrimage. Means during this period, no, Buddhism flourished in India and all. So that number of people became attracted towards Buddhism. They wanted to visit India and visit those places. They want to learn from Buddhist monks. So they used to come to India. So Fahian, he was one of the person who visited India during this period. He stayed in India and he also recorded whatever he felt and he saw during his period, during his stay in India. So all these records are considered as important source of the Gupta period. Again, we discuss about Allahabad pillar inscription. One pillar is there. In that pillar, you know, some writings are there. No, those writings are the important source of the Gupta period. Number of sources are there, okay? As historians, no, they are just like CID, no? Like you see, presently the case is going on, Sushant case is going on. So CBI is investigating the case. So they cannot simply guess something, they cannot make a story what has happened. They have to prove that whether it is a suicide or a murder. So they have to question number of people. They have to collect evidences from, they have to diary, go through the diary notes. They have to go for other evidences like electronic devices, their chat, many number of things they have to collect. And they are given 45 days, then they have to study in detail to reveal the truth. This is the same thing what the historian also does. So he mainly depends upon sources. So for Gupta Empire, in order to reveal the history of Gupta period, we have two important sources we will discuss in this chapter, that is Fahian's accounts and then Allahabad pillar inscription. So in the next class we will discuss in detail about these sources, and then we discuss also about the important rulers of Gupta Empire and its importance.